Now we will be starting with our fifth module. The fifth module is all about solid state microwave devices. So under this fifth module, we will be starting now with the tunnel diode, that is the microwave tunnel diode. Okay, and in this particular section, that is a part one, we will be seeing about the tunnel diode, its basic construction and its basic principle of working, the conditions required for tunneling, and we can also see the working of tunnel diode, the IV characteristics of tunnel diode. So these are the things which we will be seeing in this particular section. Now remember that the tunnel diode is also called as Isaki diode. Okay, so tunnel diode, as a name suggests, it is a PN junction diode. But the property of the diode is a negative resistance property. That is, the electric current will decrease as the voltage increases. So this is a basic principle of a tunnel diode or a Isaki diode. And the circuit symbol of tunnel diode is as shown. Okay, so obviously it is a PN junction diode. So it works basically on the principle of negative resistance. Now the tunnel diodes, they are mainly made from the germanium material. They can also be made from the materials like gallium arsenide, gallium antimonide and silicon. Now we know that we are having a cathode and an anode here shown. So cathode, it will be a negatively charged electrode which is going to emit the electrons, and anode is what? A positively charged electrode which is going to attract the electrons. So here the n-type semiconductor is going to emit or produce the electron, so it is referred to as the cathode, and the p-type semiconductor is going to attract the electrons emitted from the n-type semiconductor, and so the p-type semiconductor is here referred to as the anode. So now we will come to the principle of operations of the tunnel diode. Tunnel diode, also called as Isaki diode, we have already stated the basic principle that it is going to work as a negative resistance PN junction diode. Obviously, we know what you mean by negative resistance. We have already seen. So how is this negative resistance created? It is by the tunneling effect of the electrons in the PN junction. Now, in the construction of tunnel diode itself, we are keeping both the P and the N regions, both of them to be heavily doped. Okay, and the impurity concentrations of 10 raised to 19 to 10 raised to 20 atoms per centimeter cube are used. So both the junctions, they are being heavily doped, and the depletion layer is very much thin, say in the order of 100 angstrom or 10 raised to minus 6 centimeter. So here, for the principle of operation of our Isaki diode, we are going to consider the quantum mechanical theory. That is, according to, kindly observe the figure. So according to the classical mechanics, electrons, if they has to cross this particular potential barrier, the electrons or the charged particles, they should be having an energy which is equal to or greater than the potential barrier. Then only this electron, say, can climb this barrier. That is what is written. Classical mechanics, electrons must climb the potential barrier hill to appear on the other side. So this is shown for the classical mechanics. But for the operation of our Isaki diode, we consider the quantum mechanics. And according to quantum mechanics, the condition is that if the barrier, say, is less than 3 angstrom, then the particles will tunnel through the potential barrier even if they do not have enough kinetic energy to pass over the same barrier. So even if the electrons or charged particles, they are not having energy equal to or greater than the potential barrier height, according to quantum mechanics, they can still tunnel through the potential barrier and reach the other side of the barrier, provided that the barrier is lesser than 3 angstrom. So we consider for the operation of tunnel diode the quantum mechanics theory. Okay, so the first condition for the working of tunnel diode we have already seen, that is the barrier thickness must be very much small. So according to the quantum mechanics, a charged particle can tunnel through the barrier. That was our first condition. Now we will see the second condition. What is the second condition? There must be filled energy states on one side and empty states on the other side. That is, when you are considering the energy band diagram, so this is the energy band diagram for our tunnel diode. And when you are observing this energy band diagram, the necessary condition for the tunneling to take place is that how the tunneling must occur, it should obviously occur from the filled states to the empty states. So for this to occur, we know that the filled state and the empty states, they should be occurring at the same level. That is, we know that there should be what, empty states in the p-type material and there should be filled states in the n-type material, and they should be occurring at the same level. Okay, and also since the tunnel diode is being heavily doped, Fermi level exists in the valence band in p-type and Fermi level exists in the conduction band in n-type. That is, in the energy band diagram, we can observe what, their Fermi level. When you are considering for the p-type material, the Fermi level, it will be existing in the valence band. As you can see, the Fermi level is lying below the valence band in p-type, and for the n-type, the Fermi level is lying above the conduction band. So this is the second condition. So remember the most two important condition for the working of the tunnel diode. So coming to the details of how a tunnel diode is going to work. So first step, say unbiased tunnel diode. What do you mean by unbiased tunnel diode? That is, there is no voltage is applied to the tunnel diode. It is said to be an unbiased tunnel diode. So we are not going to apply any voltage for our PN junction, or we can also call it to be an open circuit. So what happens during a open circuit condition? That will be explained first, and then we go on to apply the voltage. Okay, so we start initially from our open condition, then we go on to increase our voltage step by step. So first condition, that is a tunnel diode under zero bias equilibrium, and then we go on to apply the voltage. So what happens during this open circuit conditions? That is, we can observe from the energy band diagram, the upper levels, that is what is written here, the upper levels of the electron energy of both the p-type and the n-type, they are lined at the same Fermi level. So you can see the Fermi level, that is the upper levels of electron energy for the both, they are lined at the same Fermi level for both the p-type and the n-type. Now we know that when will tunneling take place? The tunneling will take place from the filled state to the empty state. The electrons can tunnel only if the filled state and the empty state, they are of same levels. But that is not going to happen at this particular open circuit condition. So there is no filled states on one side of the junction that are at the same energy level as the empty allowed states on the other side. So therefore, no electrons can tunnel here, and obviously the current will be zero. Okay, there is no flow of charge in the either direction across the junction, and the current is going to be zero. So remember, this is our first step, that is, we are having unbiased tunnel diode, no voltage is being applied. So here we can observe that the filled state and empty state, they are not aligned at the same level. So no electrons can tunnel here from the N region to the P region. And when you observe the energy band diagram, what conclusion you can draw? The upper level of the electron energy, they are lined up at the same Fermi level. That is, upper levels are aligned at the same level and you cannot have the electrons tunneling. Therefore, the current will be zero. Now, we have seen the first step in the working of tunnel diode. That is, we are having an open circuit condition and no voltage is applied. So when no voltage is applied, from the energy band diagram, we have seen that the Fermi levels of both the n-type and the p-type, they were at the same level. So the electrons could not tunnel from n to p and the current was zero. Okay, now what is the next step? Second step, we are going to apply, say, a very small voltage to the tunnel diode. Say it is from the range of 0 to Vp. Vp here is the peak voltage. Okay, so we assume that we are going to apply the voltage to the tunnel diode step by step. Okay, so now we have started increasing our voltage. Okay, say it is in the range of 0 to Vp. So what happens in the energy band diagram? In the energy band diagram, you can see that the difference in Fermi level is being created for the n-type and p-type. That is, now it is not exactly in the same level. Okay, and you can see between the filled energy states and the empty energy states, there is some type of overlapping. So we can say some electrons here can tunnel here from the n region to the p region. So since the tunneling is taking place, what happens? There will be increase in current, and you can say that the forward tunneling is occurring from p type to n type. That is, electron flow from the n region to p region. So forward tunneling current from p type to n type. Okay. So when you are asked to explain, kindly give this energy band diagram and then try to explain. That is, when you are increasing the voltage, obviously we know first step, potential barrier is decreased. Obviously, from the working of diode, we know when we start applying a positive voltage, the potential barrier will be decreased. So what happens? Energy levels on the N side are raised relatively to P side, thus creates a difference in Fermi levels. That is, in the N region, since the potential barrier is increased, the energy levels are being slightly raised. So a difference in the Fermi level is created, which is causing the overlapping of some levels, that is between the filled states and the empty states. So the electrons in the conduction band of the N side, that is a filled state, see the empty state at P side across the barrier. Okay, so what happens? The electrons will tunnel through the barrier from the N region to the P region, thus giving rise to a forward tunneling current from the P type to the N type. That is what is explained here. So this is what is indicated here. That is a small voltage applied to the tunnel diode, which is our second step. So as the tunneling occurs here from the N region to P region, we are getting a small tunneling current from the P to N. And as you can see the IV diagram, that is a current voltage diagram, a small tunneling current occurs. That is, in the voltage ranges of 0 to the peak voltage, the tunnel current, it will go on increasing. So this region is not the negative resistance region of a tunnel diode. So it will create a small forward bias tunnel current. That is, the tunnel current starts flowing with a small application of voltage. Now we will see the next step. So in the next step, we know we are increasing the voltage step by step. So we have started increasing it, say from 0, and we are increasing it step by step till Vp. So now the voltage is going to reach Vp. Okay, that is a peak voltage or the maximum forward bias voltage for a tunnel diode. That is, V is reaching the Vp. That is the third step. So what happens in this case? So I have shown here the energy band diagram for the two conditions, that is V ranging from 0 to Vp, we have already seen. So a small tunneling is occurring here from the N region to P region. But when V is reaching Vp, you can see the change in the energy band diagram. That is, here the empty states and the filled states, they are completely overlapping with each other. So maximum tunneling is occurring from the N region to the P region. So maximum tunneling current is going to occur from the P to N. Okay, so at this point you can call the tunneling voltage to be maximum, that is forward maximum voltage Vp, and the maximum tunnel current, okay, that we denote it as Ip. So maximum number of electrons can now tunnel through the barrier. Tunneling occurs from the filled states in the N type to the empty states in the P type, giving rise to the P current of Ip. So current is here increasing, as you can see in the IV diagram, the current increases here and the maximum peak current Ip occurs when V is equal to Vp. Why? Because we know that the filled state and the empty states, they are at the same level and maximum tunneling is going to occur. So to understand this difference only, I have shown the energy diagram once more. For V ranging from 0 to Vp, as you can see, small overlapping, so some tunneling take place, but when V reaches Vp, fully the both of the levels overlap and maximum tunneling will take place. So maximum forward current, we will get the peak current of Ip here. Now in the next step, again we are going to exceed our peak voltage. So now the voltage is increased, say from peak value of voltage to the valley voltage. VV is nothing but the valley voltage. So further you are going to increase your bias. So what will happen in this case? Again we can see that the current is going to decrease. Okay, so in this part only we are going to get our negative resistance. That is, as you can see in the IV diagram, the current at this stage will decrease. Okay, and the slope, as you can see, is negative. So this region is responsible for the negative characteristics of the tunnel diode. So if the applied voltage is further increased, a slight misalignment of the conduction band and the valence band take place. So we can see the detailed figure of our energy band diagram. So when the bias voltage is further increased, say from VP to VV, the energy levels on the N side, they are raised high, then only a small amount of electron will tunnel from N to P. That is, again you can see that there is a misalignment and the overlapping here between the filled energy state and the empty energy state on the N and P, they have again decreased. Okay, there is no much overlapping because the energy level in the N region, as the bias is increased, they are going to be raised high. So now only a very small electron can tunnel here from the N region to the P region. So the tunneling current, we know it is from P to N, so that is also going to decrease. So this decrease in current, as the bias is going to increase, that is a suppression of tunneling we call, it is responsible for the negative resistance part of the tunnel diode. So this is a condition for voltage V varying from VP to VV. So in the next step, again we are going to increase a voltage. We are going to increase the value of voltage beyond the valley voltage of the tunnel diode. So what happens if the applied voltage is largely increased? The tunneling current drops to zero. That is, complete misalignment occurs here. So there is no overlapping region between the filled state in the N type and the empty state in the P type. Electrons will be unable to tunnel and the tunneling current is now going to drop to zero. So when you draw the IV diagram, what do you understand? Starting from zero valley of voltage to the value of the VP, we get the maximum current of IP. Then when the voltage value is further increased from the VP to VV, we get the negative resistance part of the tunnel diode. And further, when you are increasing the value of the voltage, say to infinity, we are getting a zero tunneling current. So at this particular region, you can see the characteristics is similar to that of an ordinary PN junction diode. So in this case, it is an injection current which flows here. So that is the exponential increase which is responsible here, is when you are increasing the voltage value beyond the valley voltage of the tunnel diode. So you can see the detailed figure in the energy band diagram. So see this, at a very large bias voltage, that is value of voltage increased beyond the valley voltage of tunnel diode. Complete misalignment, that is, there is no allowed empty states in the P type at the same energy level as filled states in the N type. You can see the energy bands in the N type, they are going to raise more and more. When they become raised, there is no overlapping, so no tunneling is possible. No electrons can tunnel through the barrier and the tunneling current drops to zero. So in the IV figure, as I told, when it reaches the value of the valley voltage, what happens? There is no tunneling which is occurring. So again, when the forward bias voltage V is increased above the valley voltage of VV, ordinary injection current at the PN junction starts to flow. So this is a characteristics of our ordinary PN junction. This injection current is increased exponentially with the forward voltage as indicated by the dashed curve. Okay, so this much part we are having the tunneling current, that is a solid curve, and this dashed curve here represents the injection current. Okay, so what you can say about the total current is it is a sum total of the tunneling current and the injection current. So when we are saying about the current in a tunnel diode, it is a sum total of this tunneling current That is the current due to the phenomenon of tunneling. And when tunneling stop, we are having the ordinary injection current of the PN junction diode. So the total current will be the sum of this tunneling current and injection current, which is stated here.